Okay, so Congressman Meadows, define a principled conservative for me.
You know, I think there's two things. One is someone that holds those values of freedom and limited government, and candidly, someone who believes that the answer to all of our woes is not necessarily in Washington, D.C., but more on Main Street America. So that's one side. But a principled conservative is someone who doesn't just talk the talk, but walks the walk. And certainly the Leadership Institute trains individuals to make sure that not only are they prepared with what they believe, but they can actually act upon that. And so I have found that in Washington, D.C., principled conservatives are normally the ones that take those tough votes for limited government and freedom when everybody else may want them to go another direction.
Interesting. So we're in 2019 right now, right, going into 2020. What do you think the current state of the conservative movement is?
Well, in ways it is under attack, but in ways it's stronger than it's ever been. And part of that is because the progressive movement, the liberals, are rising up. And so it shows a stark contrast between what liberals believe is the answer for moms and dads and aunts and uncles and kids and grandkids on Main Street, and what conservatives believe. The freest societies are the ones that are the most prosperous, and you can look at that over generations. The more authoritarian a society gets, or the more that government decides who the winners and losers are, the tougher it is for people to actually prosper and get out of poverty. I've lived the American dream, came from very humble beginnings, and yet now I have the privilege not only of providing for a family, but being in the most powerful place perhaps on the face of the globe. And so that would not have happened in any other country other than America, where it allows us, regardless of who we're married to, regardless of what family we come from, whatever background, to actually be able to live that American dream and be part of really the solutions for our world. And so in that, the word conservative is not as popular as it once was. In fact, it has negative connotations. Part of that is because socialism on college campuses is believed to be a good thing. So we have to stand up for that, but those sharp contrasts, time and time again, when you compare those, you will find that ultimately conservative values always win out.
Fantastic. So I understand that a couple years back you took some Leadership Institute training.
I did.
How
I did
that help you in your career?
Oh my goodness. Well, it was life-changing. I mean, I can tell you, before coming to actually take training on how to do an interview, like now, this is probably a little easier in that I've got a friendly person asking me questions,
thank you.
someone who's smiling back. I can tell you, it doesn't always happen that way on ABC or NBC or some of the cable news networks.
Sure.
In fact, many times you're not even looking at somebody like we're looking at each other today. You're looking at the lens of a camera. And so that training that I had from the Leadership Institute allowed me to basically go on TV to articulate what I wanted to, the message I wanted to get across, and do it in a way that will actually get me invited back. And so now, fortunately, we can probably go on any television network that we want to for any particular message. But a lot of that training came right here from the Leadership Institute.
Great. Well, thank you. We hope that for all of our Leadership Institute
attendees. I'm sure they may not see its value when they're taking it, but ultimately it produces great fruit.
Great. So what is your hope for the future of the conservative movement?
Yeah, I think what I would love to see, and the Leadership Institute has been a critical part of that, is that conservative movement actually flourish on college campuses. If you look at the liberals, they have had the college campuses much to themselves, and yet a number of people involved, the conservatives on campuses, if they're bold enough to speak out, they find that other people actually agree with them. And so my hope is that we have an incubator in the institutions of higher learning that actually work into the workforce and the places of government. It's not that way right now. In fact, it's just the opposite. But that's my hope, and I think that, you know, some of the fine work you're doing here will start that in earnest.
Congressman Mark Meadows, thank you so much for speaking with me today.
No, thank you. It's great to be with you.
Great, thank you.